Hello dear learners, myself Dr. Mini Sharma. Today I'm going to share with you a very important topic from Pedagogy of English, that is methods of teaching foreign language. Dear learners, there are many methods of teaching a foreign language like grammar translation method, direct method and bilingual method. I will be taking up with grammar translation method. I will briefly discuss what grammar translation method is, the various basic principles underlying grammar translation method and the merits and the limitations associated with grammar translation method. But before actually beginning with what grammar translation method is, I want to share with you what is a method and why do we need a method. Dear learners, the choice of method is very important for the success of teaching learning process. Method is a procedure or technique which is adopted by the teacher in order to make her lesson effective and easy. Method consists of a series of steps, for example, planning, sharing the content, and evaluating learner's performance. It helps a teacher to organize her material, her lesson effectively. Dear learners, let us discuss grammar translation method in detail. Well, grammar translation method is a classical method of teaching a foreign language, in our case, English. It has been used by teachers since a long time. This method is an old method of teaching a foreign language. You must have heard from your elders that how they were taught English in their classrooms. It was like their teachers used to translate English language into their mother tongue. There's a prominent role of mother tongue in grammar translation method. As the teacher translates every word, phrase, and sentence in the English language that he or she is reading from the textbook into the mother tongue of the child. Even the grammar of the English or the foreign language is made to compare with that of the mother tongue. So here we can say that each and every aspect of a foreign language, in our case English, is taught by translating it into the mother tongue of the learner. Just for example, if the mother tongue of the learner is Hindi, the word fan will be taught by telling the students that it is the same word as pankha in Hindi. Now, dear learners, let us discuss the various principles underlying the grammar translation method. The first principle is economical manner of interpretation. Translation interprets foreign words and phrases in the best and the most economical manner. Means we are able to understand the words and phrases contained in the foreign language in a better way. Moreover, they could be learned in an economical manner. There is economy of efforts on the part of both learners and teachers learning through this method. As the learner already knows his or her mother tongue and the vocabulary contained in it, it will be easy for him or her to grasp or understand that foreign language when a comparison is made between the two, that is a foreign language and the mother tongue. Similarly, teachers need to take less pain in order to make the students understand about the topic. It will save their efforts. Second principle is assimilation of foreign phraseology. In this process of interpretation, foreign phraseology is best assimilated or accumulated. Means a child can gather maximum phrases, vocabulary, etc. of the English language through this method. Next principle is comparison helps in effective learning. The structure of the foreign language are best learnt in comparison and contrast with those of the mother tongue. Next principle is the translation method will also help the students in attempting simple exercises in composition. Students or learners can write simple compositions by making a contrast between their mother tongue and the foreign language. Next is known to unknown. The fundamental principle of proceeding from known to unknown is followed throughout. Here the known word is used for mother tongue, which is already known to the learner, and unknown is English language or any foreign language which is new for the learners. Let's have a look at the merits of grammar translation method. First merit is quick and easy. Grammar translation method is quick and easy to use. The teacher need not to give lengthy explanation in order to make students understand a particular content in the foreign language. Second merit of grammar translation method is it helps in natural way of learning. It is considered as natural way of learning through grammar translation method because here we proceed from the known to unknown. Learners already know their mother tongue, so it becomes easy for them to understand the foreign language. Next is grammar translation method also helps in retention of the words contained in the foreign language. A bond is formed between the words in English language and the mother tongue, which further helps in the retention of the target language, in our case English language, on the part of the learners. Next is rapid expansion of vocabulary. Grammar translation method also helps the learner in rapidly expanding their vocabulary of the foreign language. Translation of the words of English language in the mother tongue of the child further helps the students in enriching their vocabulary of the English language. Next is, it helps in testing comprehension. Pupils' comprehension of English or the foreign language can be speedily tested by asking them to tell in the mother tongue what they have learned about the foreign language. Next is less teaching aid requirement. There is less teaching aid requirement on the part of the teacher. She can easily make the students understand the target language. Next is saves teachers' labor. Grammar translation method helps in saving the teacher's labor, as again she need not to give lengthy explanation to the students in order to make them understand the particular content in the foreign language. Also, she needs less teaching aids, and which also further helps to save teachers' labor. Practical method of teaching. Grammar translation method is a practical method of teaching in higher classes because it takes less time. Learners, let us discuss the various limitations that are associated with grammar translation method. The first is neglects speech. The greatest weakness of grammar translation method is that it neglects speech. It lays stress only on reading and writing. There is no scope left for oral work. Next is exact translation not possible. Each language is a unique system. No two languages are alike or similar. Languages are the product of different cultures, histories, traditions, customs, manners, and life of the people. That is why one language cannot be completely translated into the another. Next limitation that is there in the grammar translation method is that it lacks fluency. This happens because the child never acquires the habit to think in foreign language, in our case English. He first thinks in the mother tongue and then translates his thoughts into English. Consequently, they mix up the mother tongue and the English in their speech. Next limitation that is there in the grammar translation method is that it is an unnatural method. As language is first and foremost a spoken thing. Hence, the first step in language learning is speech. Reading and writing comes afterwards. Translation methods, however, inverts this natural order, because in this method, language starts with the teaching of reading. Next limitation is dull and mechanical method. In this method, the child becomes a passive listener only. He does not take part actively in the learning process. There is hardly any scope for him or her to take
part in any activity in the classroom. The method is bookish, hence uninteresting. The child learns a living language when he or she takes part in the teaching learning process. Next limitation is emphasis on rules. The method attempts to teach language through rules rather than through use. Next limitation that is there in the grammar translation method is that there is lack of English atmosphere in the classroom, as there is constant use of mother tongue both by the learners and the teachers. Next limitation that is there in the grammar translation method is that it is a bookish method. Too much use of mother tongue. It retards the students' progress in learning the foreign language. They hardly make use of English words or sentences in the classroom. There is no opportunity for silent reading on the part of the students. Incorrect pronunciation. It does not help the students to acquire correct pronunciation in the target language or the foreign language, as they don't make use of the foreign language or the words contained in it, the sentences contained in it, in their regular classroom learning. While concluding, dear learners, we can say that grammar translation method, though ineffective, it contains a number of limitations, but continues to be used by a vast majority of teachers. Because of its ease of administration, ease of use that is related with the grammar translation method. Therefore, its impact seems to be everlasting.